As you might know, the ketogenic diet is a very popular topic here at The Truth About Cancer. It's a great diet to fight inflammation in your body if done correctly.
Dr. Thomas Seyfried, who's a specialist on this topic, talks more in this short video about how fasting and the keto diet may help fight cancer. Take out your pencils and notebooks and listen carefully. You'll want to take notes.
So we have here normal epithelial cells. Now, these cells can get damaged from any one of the oncogenic paradox issues. They start to proliferate. They start to increase in the microenvironment. Cells of our immune system now come in because they see this as a wound. They have wound healing capabilities. The macrophages throw out growth factors and cytokines to put the wound out, but in so doing, it makes these blue cells grow even faster. So our own bodies have a counteractive, we're fighting against each other. They're doing an inappropriate thing, but they're programmed to do that. These cells will actually fuse with some of the cells to help put out the fire, right, these macrophages. And in so doing, they dilute their normal mitochondria in the cytoplasm. Now, these macrophages now become corrupted. These are the most powerful cells in our body. They evolved to kill bacteria and keep us healthy from the environment. This is like the police department and the militia being corrupted in your own society. Bad problem. Rogue macrophages. They're programmed to enter and exit the circulatory system. They're programmed to shut down immune responses. These are a tough cell to kill. They live in hypoxic environments, making them very difficult to kill. And they love glutamine. They love glutamine. So you have to know that. So if most cancer cells obtain energy through fermentation, what can we do? One strategy is try to reduce fermentable fuels and give them non-fermentable fuels. So what we do is we use calorie-restricted ketogenic diets, therapeutic fasting, and this kind of thing that we've heard about today. So here's a number of things about calorie restriction. The important thing here is that calorie restriction and restricted ketogenic reduce blood glucose levels, the fermentable fuel, and elevate ketone bodies, a non-fermentable fuel. So what we're trying to do is just simply take away the driving fuel that makes the beast go and giving it something that it can't use. And also, this enhances the mitochondria in normal mitochondria. It starts to make them healthier. But when I use, I'm going to show you calorie restriction in the mouse. But CR in the mouse equates water-only therapeutic fasting. And we heard that from Dr. Group this morning, which was very interesting. So when I talk about calorie restriction in mice, if you want to get the same effect, you have to stop eating and just drink water, all right? Now, we use ketogenic diets. Oh, this is a big mystery. Oh, this diet, that diet, you know, you have Atkins diet, this diet. You know, it's a very low-carb diet, but the carbs, the proteins, and the fats all play a very important role in ketogenic. That's not all the same. Many different forms of ketogenic diets. Important thing, don't eat too much of this. If you eat too much, you get insensitivity and make the damn tumor grow faster. You have to, food is medicine. If you don't know how to use the medicine, you could harm yourself. You need people that know how to do this stuff. Okay, the goal here is if you want to manage, or at least the first step in trying to manage the disease, is we've got to lower the blood sugar and we've got to elevate the non-fermentable ketones, and then we can slow this guy down. I'm not saying we cure him or we resolve. I just say we slow it down, because if we can slow it down, we can make him vulnerable to other forms of attack, and I'll show you about that. So this was one of the first reports that got our attention by Linda Nemley at Case Western Reserve. She took two little girls, hopeless cases, brutalized by the system. Surgery, radiation, chemo, the poor little kids lost their. So she put them on this ketogenic diet and was able to keep one kid alive for 2 more years. They were supposed to be dead very quickly. Read the original paper. And one other kid was lost to follow-up. This is the only study done in pediatric oncology that I know about where they actually got tremendous results. They don't do it. We do it in epilepsy all the time, treating little kids with ketogenic diets, but not in pediatric oncology. It's a tragedy in my point. Now, because of Linda's paper, we got very excited. So we decided to say, how are we going to be able to do this? So we just take these mice, put glioblastoma or astrocytoma cells into their brain, and then we wait a couple of days, and then we gave them calorie restriction. And I said, 40% calorie restriction is like water-only therapeutic fasting. And you can see this large tumor on the guy. This is standard diet, unrestricted, which is a high carbohydrate diet, high carbs. And this is same diet, just restricted the 40%, and we get anywhere 65 to 85% reduction in the size of the tumor. And each square here is a mouse under a different dietary condition. So as glucose goes down, ketones go up. This is an evolutionarily conserved adaptation to what happens when we stop eating. Ketones go up, because the brain has to have an energy taking away the glucose. As glucose goes down, the size of the tumor goes down. This was our work in the mouse. It has since been replicated in human glioblastoma, human breast cancer, colon cancer, all these different cancers. The higher your sugar, the faster the tumor grows. The lower the sugar, the slower the tumor grows. Why is that so hard for anyone to understand? Why in oncology clinics you give cake and ice cream to the kids? It's clear, and it's been replicated over and over again.
Wow, that's great information about the ketogenic diet.
Yeah, the ketogenic diet is not a fad. It's a diet that's based on science. And I think Dr. Thomas Seyfried enlightened us a little bit about that science. It goes way back. You know, the original ketogenic diet you might have heard about was called the Atkins diet, but it's not the keto diet, because the keto diet is really focused on high quality fats and moderate proteins. But you heard all of that from Dr. Seyfried just now. It's a great explanation. It is a scientifically formulated diet, and we know the research shows that it can help to remove the fuel from cancer cells, which feed on what, honey?
Sugar.
Cancer feeds on sugar.
That was a test. So I passed it.
She passed the test. 100% for you, sugar. And so,
no
great information. And so if you remove the fuel from cancer cells, they don't do very well. So thank you, Dr. Seyfried, again.
Yes, thank you. And thank you out there for watching. Until next time, God bless.